Hey everybody, I'm Garrett with Diary of a Family. Today I'm going to share my experience with crewing on a balloon during the Balloon Fiesta. The Balloon Fiesta was absolutely incredible. One of the aspects that I really enjoyed was being able to get in a hot air balloon and go and fly. I'm going to tell you a bit about my experience with crewing on the Sundance 3 and a few tips that might help you be able to fly for free. Now, it does cost to get into the Fiesta. However, if you want to go fly in a balloon, normally you're paying about $500. I don't know about you, but I don't really have $500 sitting around for a hot air balloon ride. What I ended up doing was going and joining a crew. It was a fun experience. It was a unique experience, and let's start from the beginning. A word of caution for anyone considering crewing on a balloon: if you are not a morning person, you are not going to enjoy it. If you can stand getting up at 4 in the morning to be there by 5:30 or 6, then by all means give it a try. What I did is I went down super early in the morning, and trust me, 4:30, 4:45 in the morning, you are standing in line to get through security. It is not a walk through the door, nobody's there. Everyone is there at 4:30 in the morning. Be aware of that. Now, when I got to the balloon grounds, I followed the maps to where you could sign up to be a part of a crew.
Today is our first full day of the Balloon Fiesta. I'm actually working on getting on a crew right now, and once they get their keys, I will get registered, and I'm going to be helping a crew on J11. So it's going to be awesome.
Now, they have positions for basically any kind of person. I think it's 16 and up. You have to be a little bit older. Little kids can't really join. They can watch and look forward to the day that they're old enough to be able to join. Then they have a job pretty much for anyone. Now, there are tons of balloons there, and each of them needs a certain amount of people to be able to get their balloon up in the air. What I ended up doing was I went and I said, hey, I'm willing to help out if there's anybody that needs a crew. Well, a lady came up to me and was like, are you waiting to crew? I'm like, yep. She's like, well, don't ask anymore. You're on my crew. It's like, okay. She was Mrs. Paisley from the Sundance 3. I absolutely had a blast. A little history of the Sundance 3. They've been flying balloons for over 30 years. So they've been in it for a while. They are from North Carolina, and I have family in North Carolina. And he reminded me a lot of my grandpa on my mom's side. I joined them and we got there early. We got put in our slot. Then we went to our briefing. Every morning there is a pilot's briefing. There you'll learn what the weather's like, if there's gonna be fog rolling in, what the wind pattern is like, and then the Dawn Patrol heads up. The Dawn Patrol makes sure that the weather is as it says, and they predict kind of where the patterns are. Now, as the day gets along, the weather patterns do change. That's why balloons try to leave early in the morning, because the weather itself is fairly predictable and stable. You don't want to get up in high winds or anything like that, or it can get pretty dangerous for the balloons. That was a lot of fun. I ended up crewing with Sundance 3. John Paisley out of North Carolina, and had an absolute blast. Learned a lot about crewing and the balloons and all of that. However, the weather was not very nice for us. We ended up not being able to take off. There was a heavy fog that peeked in, which messed up our ability to take off. By the time all the fog cleared, the wind had kicked up too high, so we were not able to take off. But hopefully we'll be able to come in tomorrow and get to do it all over again. Got a nice workout getting the balloon set up. I was the one who held down the crown line, which was a job for burly men and not for wimpy people. But we had a blast. and at least have one more day of this, which we're looking forward to. Day two was a very different day from the first day that we crewed. I really wish that I could have been able to stay longer for the Fiesta, because the Fiesta went pretty much 8 days. And most of those balloon crews were there the entire time. We were only able to be there for a couple days, which was kind of a bummer, but it gives us something to look forward to next time we go. Now, day two, the weather was a whole lot calmer. There was no fog, and that was really nice. We got there at our site really early, had the briefing, and then we went and we unpacked the balloon. I was actually able to fly. And after we take off, I'll show you kind of that process. One member of the whole process that I want to make sure to mention is the zebras. And the zebras are the ground control crew that work with the tower and make sure that everybody launches safely. They're all taking off when they are told to during their waves. With 800 balloons, you have to have people coordinating, even on a field that size. When you kind of unroll everything and then you get the go ahead to start the next step. And then once that step is done, if everything is still good, you'll get permission from the zebras to go and start the next step. I was on the crown line again. It was a very cool process to see the balloon go all the way up. There came a point where they're like, come in, come in, come in. And hey, we got the clear to go take off. So I jumped in and got my backpack. Carolyn and the kids were able to watch me actually take off, which was really cool.
Not yet.
Okay.
Ready to go?
We will be.
Okay, yep. As soon as you're boy, we'll get you out of here. We need a launch ticket.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, get it.
Here, take it out.
And we're going to walk you out a tiny bit to launch, okay?
Thank you. Okay, guys, hands on. We're going to walk us out.
You take your time. You tell us when you're ready.
Let me know when I'm like. Okay, let me know. Staying up. Thanks, guys. See ya. Thank you.
The kids really, really enjoyed the whole process of seeing the balloons take off, and it gave them a reason to get up early in the morning. The flight itself, after we took off, was really cool. We were able to see a lot of the city. It was amazing being able to float through the air with all the other balloons.
So you have to learn that. You see the light? I'm trying to light up the damn light over here. That's why I'm climbing to get over. See that tower? It's something you should make sure I know that it's there.
Okay. The cell tower, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
See, these guys are already landing. which is probably smart.
One of the downsides was we didn't have some of the current maps, like a GPS or whatnot. And so we tried to find a place to land. And we were looking at, just trying to look at maps, and really and truly, it took us about 15 minutes of looking at the map after we landed to find where exactly we landed. To say that it's easy to watch yourselves and keep track of where you're at on a map is pretty difficult. We found a place that we thought looked okay to land, and we went in to land. It turned out that it was in a lady's field that was not happy about people coming and flying balloons in Albuquerque. We didn't know that. One of the things that you sign a bunch of different waivers, you sign like a death waiver, obviously, you sign a no liability waiver, and then you acknowledge that you could potentially be landing in a place that's restricted. There are Air Force bases, and there's Indian reservations and other places in that area that could be possible to land in. And a lot of those, you have to go through certain security checks if you land there. So let's say you land at the Air Force base, then you have to wait till you're cleared for someone to come and take you off the base. If you land on the Indian reservation, they only escort like one person off at a time. So if like 10 or 20 balloons there, you could be up there for 4 hours just sitting there waiting for someone to escort you up and take you off. We got the not so fun one of landing in the place that was saying, don't land here. The map kind of was not clear on whether you could or couldn't land there, but basically it was not a red zone, no land zone, but also said no takeoff zone. And the takeoff zones are for some of the competitions. We landed in this spot and we tried to get the balloon down. As soon as we landed, this lady came running out and yelling just all kinds of crazy obscenities. What the heck are you doing here? Why are you here? This is a no-fly zone, and just going crazy. How are we to know? Out of the 30 years that the pilot has been flying balloons, this has never happened. We had to call the crew chief, we had to call the landowner relations team, and their only job is to deal with people and their ruffled feathers. We were sitting there trying to get our balloon packed up, and they're like, well, you can't bring any people out here. This is a freshly mowed field. And half of what they were saying did not really make a ton of sense, but it's their land, not ours, so we had to abide by their rules. As soon as the public relations people got out there, they were able to calm the owner down. We were able to get enough people out onto the field to be able to carry the balloon to where we could get access to the truck and then pull it off. So, needless to say, my first experience flying in a hot air balloon was interesting and also slightly frightening, because I was surprised that she didn't come running out with the shotgun. The way her attitude and actions were kind of seemed like it. I think that they could be a little more understanding of pilots. I think that next time we go, I hope to be able to join this crew again and be able to fly again, hopefully to a better location, one that wouldn't damage my camera or me. I didn't break anything, but I got some bruises on the landing. The landing itself was pretty rough. We landed and then we kind of hopped off the ground and slammed back down and then drug a bit on the ground. We didn't cause too much damage to the field. We got off as soon as we possibly could. The things to remember with crewing: get there early, be willing to learn, jump in and help out, be willing to help out multiple times during the week, because you'll have a better chance of getting to fly for free. Unless you have the money to be able to spend $500 to just join and go fly, then go do that and just enjoy yourself. But I think you'd appreciate it a whole lot more if you put in the time and effort to go and join a crew and go learn from them, and then you know that you helped make that flight happen. I hope you enjoyed our Balloon Fiesta series. I'm gonna put a link in the description and at the end of this video if you wanna watch our other videos regarding the Balloon Fiesta and our experiences there. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And as always, live life intentionally.